Hey guys, how are you today? Okay, so I'm going to work on creating a couple of new, one new watercolor palette, making some adjustments to another one to accommodate some new paints I got for Christmas in my collection of stuff. So the first little palette I'm going to make is, this is a Whiskey Painters palette, and this is their palette. They have a number of different palettes, and I'll try to remember to post links in the description below, but the Whiskey Painters palette and the pans are from Amazon. So if you go to Amazon and you type in Whiskey Painters palette, it's gonna pop up. They have a number of different ones. This is their one that literally is like an Altoid tin, and it's all metal, and then you can get these little half pans that have a magnet already on the bottom, and then they just stick to the palette. So we're going to, and these are fabulous, so you don't have to like put magnets on them or anything. This one's going to be a liquid pencil and graphite palette. And I've arranged it so that I can fit my watercolor graphite little tin in the palette, which I'm going to love having that. And I just have it all in one place. I got some liquid pencil paints for Christmas, and it's a set of 12 that includes the rewettable and the permanent. And for this palette, we're going to put the rewettable in here. I already did a sample painting with them. If you haven't seen my cat face painting, go back a few videos on my channel on the videos list, and it's in there for my year 2017. And I used this little disposable plastic palette to put the paints in to do that painting. Now, what I did notice is that because of the nature of these paints, they're not really a true watercolor, they're water-soluble graphite. And they probably don't have lots of gum arabic or binders or anything in them, and literally when they dried in here, like, you can just pick the whole like piece of paint up. And that's, you know, fine for just general purposes and leaving it here in the studio, but if I want to travel with it, I might get to where I'm going and have, you know, all the paints like flake out and be cakey and be weird. So that's going to be a little bit of a problem. It does make putting this in here real easy, though. So the first thing we're going to do is, this is gum arabic, which is frequently used as a binder in watercolor paint. So we're going to take some gum arabic and some a pipette, and I'm going to put a little bit in the bottom. This should also help, like, the paint blob stick to the pan. Sometimes with the more inexpensive watercolors, I have to add gum arabic to them because they, when they dry in the pans, they crack, like this liquid pencil paint is doing. Okay, and then I'm gonna need something to stir with. Let's use this old, like, knitting needle. I don't obviously use it for knitting anymore because you can see how junked up it is. Okay. So, let's see. This is gray 9. Do I want to put this in here? I think I do want to be super frugal. And this is gray 3. I'm going to put them, like, in the same order I have them here in this palette. This is sepia. And these are graphite paints that have, you know, I have two shades of gray, and then I have one, the sepia one, obviously, if you know what sepia is a brown tone. There's a yellow, a red, and a blue. And then this is the yellow one. And then the red. And the blue. Okay. And then that can be washed. And then we're going to take the tubes, and here's the gray 3. Oop, missed a piece. See, so, but I don't know what piece that is. I think it goes in there. Hopefully it goes in there. So that's gray 3. Gray 9. I have noticed some of these paints are, like, really watery, and I don't know if they're just not well mixed in the tube, or I don't know. It's odd. sepia. Yellow. Red. The blue is really pretty. I'll show you guys the cat face that I did a minute. See, there's another watery one. See if I can mix it up in the tube just a little bit. Okay, let's see if that makes a difference. Not too much. And then blue. Okay, then we're going to take our little stick and we're going to just mix them with the gum arabic at the bottom as best we can. And then you just have to let it sit out for a few days and dry up completely. Or as completely as it's going to. I'll tell you what I mean by that when we do the other one. I do want to put a little piece of watercolor paper in there. A little square. It's too big. too big. Okay, here's a little one. This will work. This is better. And a pen. And then we're going to just really quickly divide it into 6 sections. Eyeball it. You always want a little sample of what the paint looks like on actual paper, right? So we have gray 3, gray 9, sepia, yellow, red, and blue. Yep. And then a little paint. Hey guys, so my SD card on my camera got really full and I looked up and I wasn't recording. All right, so I think when the camera shut off, I was getting ready to make the little color key for these graphite paints. And I was talking about how some of the paints come out of the tube really watery. And I think what I'm gonna just do is keep like mixing them up in the tube by pushing on the tube. And these do dry down a lot, and they will sink down a lot. So I will probably add a little bit more gum arabic and a little bit more paint. I don't like them to be completely full, but I do want them to be kind of full. So I'll keep working on this and I'll update you in the future on how it works out. But here's my color key. Here are all the different colors of the rewettable liquid pencil paint. Aren't they pretty? So this is going to be a lot of fun to play with, and I should be able to, you know, take this with me if I go on a trip and, you know, I've got my regular travel palette with me, or I have this muted palette with me. I can take some of these graphite colors too, which would be a lot of fun to play with. So we're going to set this aside. It's got to dry completely. Now, this is my Daniel Smith muted palette, and I got some of these M. Graham colors to try. You guys have been asking me to try and review them on camera for a while. I know Lindsay the Frugal Crafter really likes these paints, and I can see why. If you go back again to my cat face video, you will see where I actually use these along with the graphite, the liquid pencil paints, to create the cat face. These are really great colors. I do think they would lend themselves very well to the muted palette. And I'm going to show you why, because we are going to swatch them. In the meantime, I have some of these little half pans from Whiskey Painters, and they already have the magnet on the back. And because this is a little tray inside, has, I can't get it out. Okay, this little tray has this space in the middle between the two rows of paint. These actually fit in there very well, and because they're magnetized, they aren't going to go anywhere. Now the M. Graham paints do have a honey binder, which means that, what does that mean? That means that they never really dry out completely. They always stay sticky. These are, and you won't be able to really tell on camera, but maybe you can just kind of see how that's kind of sticking to my finger. They never really dry completely, like the Daniel Smith paints dry completely. The M. Graham ones don't. So we're gonna add these to the palette. I do want to add them in the same order. I think that they're here in the box. I think I want to do that. Yeah, I think so. All right, so I do want to put these in here, this part that's in here. And because they're not dry completely, they're gooey, and they stay gooey, it should be not a problem to scrape most of the paint out and then get it in there. See? Nope, it worked great. So I'm going to wipe off my palette knife. So that's a quinacridone rust, which is not in this palette, which I call my muted palette. They're kind of like deserty, muted, earthy colors. And this is a really fun palette to paint from. And it's a limited color palette, which is a challenge, which I enjoy. So it's a fun palette to paint with. All right. That one was, what was that, yellow ochre. This one is Indian yellow. And these are all happen to be colors that are not in this palette. So I thought they would be a nice addition, again, to this palette. This one is mineral violet. And the last one is turquoise. Now these M. Graham paints do come in 5 tube sets like this. And this is the Desert Southwest set. They have a bunch of different ones. You can get the tubes individually too, but these little sets are fun. Okay, so now we're going to go back to the beginning, and we are going to start with the quinacridone rust, and we're going to finish adding to our palette. Okay. And yellow ochre. And then I'll show you how I think we're going to add to the color key that goes in here. Because I like to have a sample, a swatch of the colors on a piece of paper so that I can just have it out while I'm painting, and I know by looking at the swatches what my paint is going to look like on paper. I feel for me as a watercolorist, that's really important for me. Especially because a lot of the colors you can see here, they all look at this like the same color, some of them in the pan, and you can't really tell until you put them to the paper what they actually are. All right, so there we go. So you can put that away. I'm gonna set this aside over here. I need to keep the gum arabic out because I might need that later for the other palette. So here is the color key from this set. So I think what I'm going to do is actually split this down the middle. Carefully. Okay. I'm going to zoom in. Okay. So I'm going to take a black pen, and I'm going to write on each one of the existing swatches in the corner, DM. Oh, and a finer point pen, because that one's a little too fat. Let's get the Sharpie pen. Okay. Oh yeah, that's better. Oh, DM. Why am I putting DM? Should be DS. Oh, you guys. Why didn't you stop me? Ay, ay, ay. Well, now it's going to be on there forever. So, hold on. It's a good thing nobody sees these little swatches but me. Well, and you guys. This is just your basic office supply store. Wet now. Whiteout tape. So DS for Daniel Smith. Holy cow. To dry that. Okay. Okay. Daniel Smith, DS. Okay. Then we're gonna cut this scrap piece of paper to the same length as these other strips. Okay. It's literally just a scrap I did something else on. It was pen testing or something. Then we're going to divide it into 5 sections. Okay, and we're going to put a MG for M gram at the bottom. And then the color name at the top. And you know what? I put the paint away, it's okay. So, Cuadro Rust. Yellow Ochre. Indian yellow. Mineral violet. And turquoise. Okay. Then we're going to take some tape. Rip off a piece longer than what you need. And I'm going to put the top. What's going to be the new middle? Okay, and then the end. Cut off the extra tape. And I'm actually going to stick it down here just to make sure everything's good and stuck. Sounds like a German word, good and stuck. Probably is. It probably means something nasty. All right. Don't mind me. My brain's all over the place today. All right, so then when I put it in the palette, I can just do this to when I'm closing things up, but when I'm painting, I have all my colors. I think that's very clever. Okay, so now we're going to swatch these new colors that go in here. And when you're swatching these fresh straight out of the tube paint straight out of the tube. You just need the teeniest, tiniest bit of paint, especially when you're using an artist color like these that are super well pigmented. I mean, look at that rust color. This is yellow ochre. And these colors, I think, are going to complement the Daniel Smith colors in here very, very well. This is the Indian yellow. Nice and bright, bright, warm yellow. Here is the mineral violet. Oops. There we go. Actually get some on my brush. There we go. I'm trying not to pick too much, but maybe I'm taking too much care. So it's a beautiful purple color. And then the turquoise. Oops. I think I need more of a violet on there. This pink. Being too cautious. There we go. So there you go. So they're beautiful colors. And again, I can just leave this out and let it dry out as much as it's going to for a couple of days. Like I said, they will stay sticky, but this closes first and then the top closes, and I will always make sure my color key is between this layer and that layer so that they don't get the color key all goopy. You know, you can always stick a piece of plastic in there or something if you're super worried about it. I'm not. I never fill my pans up all the way to the top, so I don't really worry about them overflowing or anything like that or getting stuck to the lid. All right, and that's it for right now. I hope that gave you some ideas of what you can do with some of your paints to make up some interesting palettes, gave you some idea of some interesting new products that are out there. I have lots more stuff coming up. Don't forget to support my channel if you can, and go to the YouTube channel's main page and hit that fan funding button, or better yet, go over to my Etsy shop and go do some shopping over there. Things ship usually within 2 or 3 days unless I'm out of town. And if I'm out of town, then the shop is closed. So that'll give you a clue. All right, and don't forget the most important thing. Go out and have a great day. Do something nice for yourself because you deserve it, and I'll see you later. Bye, guys.